This video is on a project that I've been spending many hours on in the last few months. It involves the construction of a small wafer stepper. I'm trying to build it mostly from used parts, for example from eBay or from previous projects. And building a wafer stepper is actually a combination of many disciplines such as optics, mechanics, electronics and software. And in this video, I'll mainly focus on the optical aspects of this project and save the mechanics and electronics for a future video. For those of you who are not familiar with the concept of a wafer stepper, wafer steppers are the machines that help create the tiny patterns in integrated circuits. They're actually very complex machines. Now, owning a wafer stepper is generally speaking not very useful. It's a very expensive machine, and in addition, it requires a multi-million dollar infrastructure around it in order to actually produce microchips. So, why would you want to build one? Well, I don't want to produce chips, but I want to make micro-optics. Now, just to give you an idea of what I mean, one of the most fascinating emerging fields in optics is the development of so-called metasurfaces. Basically, a metasurface is a flat optical element that is produced in a similar manner as a computer chip. Now, unlike conventional optics that have curved surfaces to refract light, they are completely flat and their surface contains a complex diffractive pattern. Now, at each point on the surface, the pattern diffracts a passing optical wavefront in a specific direction. And I think that metasurfaces might very well cause a revolution in the development of optical components. Now, there's a few videos on YouTube about the subject and I will post links in the description. But making metasurfaces is something for the future. Before I can start making anything at all, I need to have a tool first. And my plan was to build something by which I can freely goof around with different exposure patterns. So, the wafer stepper that I'm building is maskless. It works by projecting a strongly demagnified image of patterns generated by the projection chip of a standard DLP beamer. The concept is illustrated in this image. Here is a UV light source and the light is condensed on a DMD chip. The image on the DMD chip is then reflected into a microscope objective and then projected on a wafer. The DMD chip that I'm using is actually from an Acer P1500 beamer used in a previous project. It has a resolution of approximately 2 megapixels, so basically the resolution of a high definition computer screen. Now, this resolution is actually rather pathetic if you compare it to the resolution of, let's say, a modern wafer stepper, because these machines can write a data equivalent of many terabytes per exposure, so a few million times more. So does this make my machine useless? Well, it's not the ideal choice for mass production, but you can do other things, for example, image stitching. And in this way, you can extend the dimensions of the pattern to basically as large as you want. So, let's say we want to make a diffractive lens of more than 2 millimeters in diameter, and we only have an exposure field of 0.7 by 0.4 millimeters. Now, with a maskless stepper, we can just chop up the pattern into 25 individual exposures and then step through the pattern one image at a time. In addition, we can project grayscales with a DMD chip to correct for the resolution limitations of optical systems. Due to diffraction, a square shape in the object will have more or less rounded corners in the projected image, especially when we go near the limits of the optical resolution. But by tweaking the grayscales in the projector, we can actually correct for these effects, as is illustrated in this picture. We can also do multiple overlapping exposures in succession to achieve a similar effect. And let's also not forget that the DMD mirrors can be switched on and off in the 10 kHz range. So, in principle, we can project thousands of images per second. As for the projection lens, my initial idea was to use an actual wafer stepper lens, which I had also bought on eBay. But this turned out to be highly impractical because of the enormous size and weight of the lens and the 1 meter long optical path. Now, in addition, the lens only has a demagnification factor of 5 times, which is too limited if you want to go to submicron resolutions. So instead I decided to take a different approach and buy a Nikon Plan-Apo microscope objective with 20 times magnification and use this in reverse. So I use it in demagnification. Now I found a cheap OEM version of this objective for about 100 euros on eBay. And it has a relatively large projection field of 1.25 millimeters in diameter. And it also has a large entrance pupil of 16 millimeters on the entrance side. Now, in addition, its optics are UV optimized. And as you can see in this calculation, the resolving power of this objective is 329 nanometers at the intended exposure wavelength, which is actually pretty awesome. So let's look in a little more detail at the DMD chip properties and the projection. Now the total field of the DMD chip is approximately 14.5 by 8 millimeters with pixels of 7.6 microns. So if we demagnify this image by a factor of 20, we reduce the exposure field to approximately 0.7 by 0.4 millimeters and the pixel size to about 0.4 microns. Now, the size of the projection fits nicely inside the field of view of the objective. Also, the projected pixel size of 0.4 microns is larger than the minimum feature size that can be resolved by the microscope objective. So it looks as if we have a good match between the optics we will use and the resolution that we're trying to achieve. Now, just to put the dimensions of the projection in perspective, what we're trying to achieve is project the full resolution of an HD screen into the area covered by only 4 pixels in a standard computer monitor. Next, I had to get an idea of the total layout of the machine. So I had to choose which parts to use for my workshop and measure their dimensions. Now I decided to use an old XY stage as a wafer table and the piezo actuator for focusing. Using the dimensions of the parts, I made a 3D sketch to determine the layout of the machine frame. So let's quickly go through the different components. This is the UV light source, which basically consists of a 405 nanometer LED and a condensing lens. Now, the beam from the UV source is reflected by a small mirror, and this mirror reflects the light of the source at the correct incident angle for the DMD chip. The pattern on the DMD chip is then reflected in the direction of a mirror on the 45 degrees and then into the microscope objective. The microscope objective focuses the image onto the wafer stage. Next was the actual construction. I bought some aluminum plate material and thread ends at a hardware store and used it to construct the machine frame. Now, I then assembled the optics module by adding all the components to the frame. Now, I must admit that I didn't really plan this project in great detail. In fact, it was just about the fun of building something really cool. So, when I was busy constructing everything, I realized that it would be quite difficult to check the correct focus. So, at that point, I modified the design a bit, replacing the 45 degree mirror with a 50% beam splitter. And although the UV exposure power is then reduced by a factor of 2, I can do detailed inspection of the focus of the projected image by just looking through the beam splitter with a camera. Let's take a brief helicopter view of the rest of the machine. The main controller card that I use to drive everything is a DynaMotion K-Flop, which can be controlled by a PC. Now, as for the mechanics, we need to drive 3 axes. So 2 axes use closed loop servo motors and one uses a piezo element. And the closed loop servo motors are actually very easy to connect because they understand the step direction signals of the K-flop controller. However, interfacing the piezo element was actually a bit more difficult because it requires an analog input voltage to set the position. So what I did was use an Arduino Due and program it in such a way that 2 of the digital inputs of the Arduino accept step direction signals. And the 12-bit digital to analog output of the Arduino is then used to generate the correct analog output voltage. The light source is switched on using a high power MOSFET and it is controlled by one of the digital ports on the K-flop card. But as I said earlier, there's just so much to tell about this that I decided to discuss the mechanics and electronics in more detail in an upcoming video. Now, another aspect that we have not discussed so far is software. I decided to write a dedicated control program in Microsoft Visual Studio, and at this point it's not completely finished. However, all the basic functionality is working. So I expect that in a few weeks' time I will be able to do image stitching and hopefully will be able to make my first meta surface. Just for fun, let's have a quick look at the movements of the three axes in the machine through the inspection camera. Now, I used a small lithographic test mask with the test pattern and placed it on the wafer stage. And the pattern is actually contained in the small transparent looking area in the center. It contains various details in the range of between 10 and a half a micron. And as you can see in the camera image to the right, it's possible to very accurately set the positions. So for the X and Y, it's possible to take steps of approximately 100 nanometers. And for the focus, each step of the piezo controller corresponds to approximately 40 nanometers of travel. Okay, that's it for now. Hope you learned something, and maybe I'll see you in the next video.